Thank you, Jack, and thank you all so much. It is great to be back with you. Jillian and I are great fans of this club. We are very honored having won the recent straw poll from the oldest running, the longest running Tea Party in the country. So thank you so much for your support for that. I will tell you, I've been here on several occasions, and I'm not sure if I've shared with you before, but I am the son of two liberal Jewish Democrats who was born in Brooklyn, New York. And so people ask me all the time, how is it possible that you could have grown up as a conservative Republican? And I remind people that I grew up during the era of Ronald Reagan being president. And I'll just share with you. It was during that time when we had moral clarity, something that we're lacking so much of here in this country today. When we understood what it meant to say, we win, they lose. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall. Well, we face right now an existential threat from Sharia-compliant Islam. And I know it's not popular for politicians to come before a group and talk about the fact that they have stood up time and time and time again, warning about this threat, speaking out about this threat. It's how come Pamela and I know each other for so many years. Because 5 years ago, when the movie Obsession, Radical Islam's War Against the West first came out, I had a showing of it in Tallahassee to show it to all the members of the Florida legislature to wake them up to what was going on in this country. I was ridiculed by CARE. When the imam who was invited by a state representative who is a Democrat from here in Broward County, when he was invited to give the morning prayer at the Florida House of Representatives, and I boycotted the prayer, I was the one ridiculed. When I invited Geert Wilders to join me for a free speech conference in Palm Beach County, not only did the hotel cancel its plans to have him come in, but I was the one who was asked by the Hamas front group, Council of American Islamic Relations, to resign from office because I was an Islamophobe and a hater. When I showed the movie The Third Jihad in Boca Raton to an audience of several hundred, I had to have a police escort take me out of the building. We need politicians today. We need leaders who have the courage to say what needs to be said and do what needs to be done. And that's not just on economic issues and social issues, but it's on national security issues as well. I've proven it time and time again, because this isn't just a threat on foreign soil. This is also a threat from those who seek to destroy us from within. Pamela shared with you all of the stories. Did you notice how many of them are taking place right here in the state of Florida? It's right here within our own community. We remember Tom Trento's video, my good friend who I joined to form the Florida Security Council with a few years back. We remember that video right on Broward County protesting, saying, send the Jews back to the oven. That wasn't in the Middle East, that was in Broward County. This threat exists. Whether it's Rivka Berry, and Pamela and I were on the front lines of that together, fighting to make sure that we kept her safe here in this state and not sent her back to Ohio. I was on the phone with the Department of Community Affairs, of Children Affairs, every single day, fighting to make sure she stayed here so she stayed alive, because no one believed us that if she went back to Ohio, she would die. I was there. I understand this news story that's just now because of you getting into the news. The stealth jihad is just as dangerous as the violent jihad. How many other candidates running for public office, the United States Senate, are going to come in here and tell it like it is? This is the time. This is the time when we need to stand up and fight. This is a battle for the heart and soul of our country. And I'm going to conclude on this one final story, because it is as disturbing as anything I have heard since I have been working on this issue of the anti-jihad. Many of you probably know that there was just recently an arrest in Miami of two imams at the mosque in Miami for funneling money to the Pakistani Taliban in order to fund them to train jihadists to kill Americans. You know that story, you read it. What you didn't read, and has been reported elsewhere, is the fact that when the FBI, our nation's law enforcement, when they went down to the imams, when they went down to the mosque to arrest the imams, they were in morning prayers. So the FBI waited until the morning prayers were over. And then after the morning prayers, before the FBI, according to these reports, before the FBI entered the mosque to arrest the two imams who were sending money to train jihadists to kill Americans, do you know what those FBI agents did? They took off their shoes. This is a battle for the heart and soul of our country. We cannot allow political correctness, multiculturalism, or appeasement cripple our defenses at home or abroad. This is the fight. We need leaders who have the courage to say what needs to be said, to do what needs to be done. I'm thankful for the Tea Party, not just for saving the Republican Party in 2010, but for what it's going to do to save this country in 2012. Thank you, and God bless you.